may stand.
Do not forget the works of the Lord. But he,
forgave his sin and destroyed them not. Often he turned back his anger and let none of his wrath be used. Do not forget the works of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to death, even death on the cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Take that greatest context, the cause of our downfall is us. God assumes our humanity again in its fullness in Jesus Christ, and ultimately that again redeems us all by his perfect sacrifice of atonement once and for all. And by participating in the gift of the Mass, we get a window into that, as it were, to be present to that moment each and every time we celebrate. Because again, it's not that Christ was, you know, sacrificed over and over again, but rather that we're participating in that gift, being brought into that same place where Jesus again can allow us to participate, just as the apostles did that very night before his ultimate sacrifice. We understand what a gift that is. We understand what a gift God gives us, and we get to participate in his divine life. He allows us in such a way that we get to take this into our own person. That it ultimately, again, this gift of grace makes us more like him each and every day in all that we receive, most especially the gift of this altar. That's unbelievable, almost. And yet it's been celebrated since the time of Jesus himself, through his apostles, through the early church, through the Middle Ages, into our current world, in this unbroken chain. There is a real gift that we are participating in each and every time we get to walk into church. We must realize just again how much of a gift it is. Because throughout the history of the world, it hasn't taken much for the enemy to stir up people in such a way that the gift can be pulled back. Not because God wants it or actively wills it, but because again, we fall into that trap of sin, as it were, and people get stirred up, and all of a sudden, this gift is not as accessible. It's happened everywhere. It's happened in the early church. You think about all the persecutions that took place in Rome, and ultimately, again, the saints Peter and Paul both gave their lives for, and again, the latter part of that first century. We can go all the way into our modern-day world. Go to the early 1920s, just south of the border of Mexico, when, again, the Mexican government shuttered the churches, you know, in a persecution and kicked out all the priests to the point that there was a rebellion by the people just to get them open again. This is not some distant thing. This gift that we have is very fragile, and it must be something that's witnessed to constantly. This is why you hear me constantly talk about bringing this gift beyond these four walls, making a witness of ourselves, of the good we have received in and through the gift of Mass, in and through the gift of encounter with our Lord's grace being poured into our hearts. Because if we don't do it, if it becomes just another thing, then suddenly freedom of religion morphs into freedom of worship. You're privatizing, you keep it in these four walls, but if you bring it out into the public square, God help you. That's not what we're called to do. Our faith is as much of our part of our person as we proclaim it to be. We need to live it in all aspects of our lives. It can't be just something we do on the side as a nice thing on Sundays or as it were this morning at daily Mass. God sacrificed too much, paid too much of a price for each and every one of us, as St. Paul records elsewhere in the Scriptures. He pours out himself for us. So on this feast of the Exaltation of the Cross, I think the least we can do is try to make the same gift, to the best of our ability, back to him. we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may find hope in the sign of Christ's victory over death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through the cross we may all come to inherit the gift of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We may be never fearful of living our faith in the midst of a world that is in desperate need of God's mercy and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead rejoice among all those saved in the paschal mystery of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we remember Father Vincent Fitzpatrick, ST, in the prayer of this liturgy, let us also offer up our own prayers to the Lord in the silence of our own hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. Good and gracious God, look into our hearts and see the gifts that we place before you. Help us, Lord, to draw that much closer to you, and in turn bring these gifts to those who most need of encountering the gift of your mercy. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May this oblation of the Lord, which on the altar of the cross canceled the offense of the whole world, cleanse us, we pray, of all our sins. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you place the salvation of the human race on the wood of the cross, so that where death arose, life might again spring forth. And the evil one, who conquered on a tree, might likewise on a tree be conquered through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together in exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending out your Spirit upon them like the dewfall. May they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more gave thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God. Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
With the kingdom, power, and glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. communion edified. When I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw everyone to myself, says the Lord. Now pray the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things. I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray.